Hi friends, this is me Fatma Salil and you are with me on Medical Topics. Today I am going to deal with the topic Anatomy of Human Heart. Today in this session we are going to go through pericardium, heart wall, chambers of heart, heart valves and great vessels. Let's check into the session. Heart is a muscular organ about the size of a fist. It is located under the ribcage to the left of our breastbone and between our lungs. The heart normally beats about 60 to 80 times a minute when at rest, but this can vary. Approximate weight of the adult human heart is between 7 to 15 ounces. Pericardium. The heart is surrounded by a double-layered membrane called pericardium. It is made up of two main layers, a tough external layer known as fibrous pericardium, a thin internal layer known as serous pericardium. Fibrous pericardium is made up of tough connective tissue and is relatively non-distensible. Serous pericardium is enclosed within the fibrous pericardium. The serous pericardium is itself divided into two layers, outer parietal layer, internal visceral layer. Outer parietal layer that lines the internal surface of the fibrous pericardium. Internal visceral layer that forms the outer layer of the heart wall, also known as epicardium. Each of these layers is made up of single sheet of epithelial cells known as mesothelium. Between the outer and the inner serous layers, there is pericardial cavity, which contains a small amount of lubricating serous fluid. This serous fluid serves to minimize the friction generated by the heart as it contracts. Heart wall. The wall of heart consists of three layers of tissue, thin outer epicardium, thick middle myocardium, very thin endocardium. Epicardium, protective layer mostly made of connective tissue. It is considered as the continuation of the serous pericardium. The epicardium refers to both the outer layer of the heart and the inner layer of the serous visceral pericardium. Myocardium. Myocardium is the muscle tissue of the heart composed of cardiac muscle cells called cardiomyocytes that receive nervous stimulation from the SA and the AV nodes via Purkinje fibers. Endocardium. Inner layer of the heart wall is the endocardium and is composed of endothelial cells that provide a smooth, non-adherent surface for blood collection and pumping. It acts as a barrier between the blood and the heart muscle. Purkinje fibers are located in the inner ventricular walls of the heart, just beneath the endocardium in a space called subendocardium. Chambers of the heart. Right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle, left ventricle. The upper chambers are called atria. They are thin-walled and act as receiving chambers. The lower chambers are called ventricle. They are thick-walled and forcefully pump blood out of the heart. The left atria and left ventricles are separated from the right atria and right ventricles by a wall of muscle called septum. A continuation of the specialist tissue of the AV node called bundle of His descends down the membranous part of the interventricular septum and serves to transmit the electrical impulse from the AV node to the Purkinje fibers of the ventricles. Right atrium. Right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from head, neck, arms and chest via major blood vessel known as superior vena cava. Deoxygenated blood from the lower body including legs, back, abdomen and pelvis is returned to the right atrium through the inferior vena cava. Natural pacemaker of the heart, SA node, is located in the upper wall of the right atrium at the junction where the superior vena cava ends. This pacemaker cell can spontaneously generate electrical impulses. AV node lies on the right side of the partition that divides the atria near the bottom of the right atrium. This AV node serves as an electrical relay station, slowing the electric current sent by SA node. Coronary sinus is a collection of smaller veins that merge together to form the sinus. This sinus collects the majority of the cardiac venous blood. Coronary sinus opens into the right atrium between the orifice of the inferior vena cava and the atrioventricular opening. Right ventricle. The lower right chamber of the heart that receives deoxygenated blood from the right atrium and pump it under low pressure into the lungs via pulmonary artery. Left atrium. Left atrium receives oxygenated blood from the lungs via four pulmonary veins and then empties it into the left ventricle. The wall of the left atrium are slightly thicker than the wall of the right atrium. Left ventricle. The left ventricle receives oxygenated blood from the left atrium and pumps it through the aortic orifice into the aorta. The left ventricle is the largest, strongest and thickest chamber in our heart because it has to pump blood out to the entire body. Heart valves. The valves prevent the backward flow of blood. The heart has four valves which are divided into two categories, atrioventricular valve and semilunar valve. Tricuspid valve and mitral valve are atrioventricular valves. Pulmonary valve and aortic valve are semilunar valves. Tricuspid valve is located between the right atrium and right ventricle. Mitral valve or bicuspid is located between the left atrium and left ventricle. Pulmonary valve is located between the right ventricle and the pulmonary artery. Aortic valve is located between the left ventricle and the aorta. The mitral valve and tricuspid valve, which control blood flow from the atria to the ventricles. The aortic valve and pulmonary valve, which control blood flow out of the ventricles. The mitral valve has only two leaflets. The aortic, pulmonary and tricuspid valves have three. The leaflets of the mitral and tricuspid valves are supported by papillary muscle and chordae tendineae. Great vessels. Great vessels are the major vessels which directly carry blood into or out of the heart. Five great vessels enter and leave the heart. Superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, pulmonary artery, pulmonary vein and the aorta. The superior and the inferior vena cava are collectively called the vena cavae. This vena cavae retains deoxygenated blood from circulation in the body and empty it into the right atrium. The vena cavae are not separated from the right atrium by valves. Pulmonary arteries. The pulmonary arteries carry deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle into the alveolar capillaries of the lungs to unload carbon dioxide and take up oxygen. These are the only arteries that carry deoxygenated blood and are considered as arteries because they carry blood away from the heart. The pulmonary artery branches into the left and right pulmonary arteries that deliver deoxygenated blood to their respective lungs. Pulmonary veins. The pulmonary veins carry oxygenated blood from the lungs to the left atrium of the heart. Despite carrying oxygenated blood, this great vessel is still considered a vein because it carries blood towards the heart. Four pulmonary veins enter the left atrium. The right pulmonary veins pass behind the right atrium and superior vena cava, while the left pass in front of the descending thoracic aorta. The pulmonary arteries and veins are both considered as part of pulmonary circulation. The aorta. The aorta is the largest artery in the body. Oxygenated blood is pumped from the left ventricle through the aortic valve into the aorta. Components of aorta. The aorta has many subdivisions that branch off into smaller arteries. These subdivisions are ascending aorta, descending aorta, aortic arch, thoracic aorta, and abdominal aorta. Apart from all these vessels, there is another important vessel known as coronary arteries. Coronary arteries that play significant role in supplying blood to heart muscle. Like all other tissue in the body, the heart muscle needs oxygen-rich blood to function. The coronary arteries wrap around the outside of the heart. These arteries and their branches supply blood to all parts of the heart muscle. Hope this crash session was useful for you guys. Please convey your comments and suggestions for support. And don't forget to like and subscribe my channel, Medical Topics.